What is that? See what's coming?
Yeah, I almost think this is better.
What?
Okay, so we just came down Old Town Road and we're in Old Town Bay Marina and we're ready to launch for our first multi-day kayaking trip. Have a look. Right? Say hi, babe.
Hi. Super excited to get on the water and out there.
So let's get going.
I wasn't able to upload this full video to my editing software. Not exactly sure why, because I'm still learning the program. So you don't get to see the ugly storm rolling in over our heads as we start packing up for our first multi-day paddle trip. We knew that there was going to be some rain and some bad weather, and we did everything that we could to prepare for it, but we had no idea what we were about to be paddling into. But that's all part of the experience, and looking back on it, it really was one of the highlights of this trip.
All right, we're off.
Yep. We are off from the Old Town Road. Oh my God! And now we have mail. Oh wow. This is insane. Oh my God. What is that? See what's coming? What?
After all the rain and hail, we were a little unsure about paddling into that thick cloud. But we brought all the gear, we knew this was coming, and we decided that we were going to push on anyways. And before too long, we could see that the clouds were starting to clear up, and the rain was slowing down, and our situation was starting to improve. By the time we rounded the point, the clouds had passed, the rain had stopped, and the sun had come out. For the first time, we were able to just relax and enjoy paddling and take in the scenery.
Oh my God!
After about a half hour or so of having a nice relaxing paddle and taking in the scenery, a strong tailwind picked up. It created some of the biggest waves that we'd been into up until this point. Not only were we having a blast riding these waves, but we were also making really good time.
Oh, look at this beach.
I don't think this is the campsite then.
You don't think so?
No.
Well, do you want to stop here anyways?
You want to stop?
Yeah, kinda.
Sure.
Just because I got
to eat.
Yeah, I'm kind of hungry.
Ironically, we stopped at Hungry Cove for a bite to eat and a quick rest. After a short break, it was time to hit the water again and make some miles. We weren't exactly sure how far it was to our first stop, since we've never been here before, but we knew we had a long ways to go, and we needed to make up some time. The next couple hours seemed to vanish, as we were taken in by the rugged beauty of the landscape. At one point, we even passed by a little cave. I paddled closer to see if I could see anything living inside, but there was nothing there. Before we knew it, we arrived at our first destination, Marble Point Campsite. It was an absolutely beautiful campsite, and we had the whole place to ourselves. After several hours of paddling, we quickly set up camp, eager to sit down and take a rest and enjoy our evening. Now that camp was set up, it was time to start a fire and get dinner going. I decided not to use the fire pit because it was full of mud, rocks, and garbage, and I didn't feel like digging it out. I was also really eager to use the portable fire pit that we had packed with us just in case. And as you can see, it was an absolutely beautiful evening. The next morning, we woke up feeling relaxed, refreshed, and ready to go. We were greeted with the beautiful morning sun, and this slimy guy crawling around the campsite.
After breakfast, we decided to explore a little bit. We soon discovered why this place is called Marble Point. There was chunks and slivers of marble everywhere you looked. After a relaxing morning, it was time to hit the water. We still had about 10 kilometers to go until we reached our next campsite. That's also where we would find the floating store. We'd both heard of the Shark Shack, but we'd never been there before, so we're pretty stoked to check it out. Plus, Sam wanted to spruce up tomorrow morning's coffee with just a little bit of Caroline's. Even though it was a beautiful day and we seemed to be making good time, I was struggling a little bit. I wasn't used to the weight of the kayak with all our gear in it. Plus, I had all the leftover firewood crammed into the cockpit with me, which meant that I couldn't move my legs around when I started to cramp up. It made this section of the journey a little bit difficult, but it was a gorgeous day. The bummer part at the end of it all was that the Shark Shack wasn't even open that weekend. We actually passed it our very first day when we were paddling through all the rain and hail. Before too long, we made it to the Cinemoose Narrows campsite. Once we got there, we set up camp, settled in, and decided to explore a little bit.
Sure. I don't know where the trail goes. I just know where we went and stopped.
Yeah, I think the trail pretty much stops.
Oh, and you just kind of got a bush back?
It's all rocky, it looks like. A little bit cooler on this side. You might regret wearing those shorts for a minute.
Doesn't feel too bad right now. Okay.
You good?
Yep. I'm gonna have to look down here.
Yeah, I think this would be acceptable time to look down.
Yeah? Flowers.
Steel cable here.
Yeah, it is a little chilly.
It is chilly.
Why don't we just sit over here?
In the sun?
A little bit.
Get a better view of the lighthouse from there anyways. Or the light tower, I guess.
Light tower. Not really much of a house, but yeah.
It's still pretty cool.
That was pretty cool.
It was another absolutely gorgeous evening, and when dinner was done, the only thing to do was sit back, enjoy the fire, enjoy our view, and relax. And a little bit later on, we even got a visit from an unexpected guest. Day 3 was another picturesque morning, but it was somewhat bittersweet, because we knew that today we would have to turn around and paddle home. But first, we absolutely had to go check out what appeared to be a pyramid on the other side of the Narrows.
So I don't know if we can see this, but we're heading out to the light tower. It has a little pyramid by it. It's paddling through the Sinamoose, right? Sinamoose Narrows. Then we're gonna head on back that way. There is lots of camping.
Again, you know, we could probably find a nice private spot, even though it's full. You got a booger.
A booger?
Captain John Joseph Smith, Barrie, Ontario.
Sorry, babe.
Brown, Shuswap Lake.
No, really. I don't think that was a booger. I think that was some lotion from putting it on my nose.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, it kind of looked white.
So. It was really white.
Unfortunately, it was time to start paddling home.
Campsite that we went to. Marble Point campsite. That's what it is. Only get here by water. That's cool.
Look up in there.
Oh yeah. Oh, neat. Coming behind you. Watch out, I'm coming behind you. Are we good enough?
2 seconds.
We stopped for one last break at the appropriately named Hungry Cove, where we met a couple of bold chipmunks, presumably looking for any morsels of food that we might leave behind.
Oh, look at them.
Soon it was time to get back on the water and make the last leg of the journey home. Before we realized it, we had paddled over 20 kilometers and reached our destination, Old Town Bay Marina. The journey was done, but the memories would last a lifetime, and we couldn't wait to come back for another adventure.